this week for some design inspiration, let's visit the home of NCR-based interior decorator Tikka Jaswinder Singh, a veteran interior designer who has designed the homes of the who's who of Delhi NCR. Mr. Singh's own house is a gorgeous space designed in the English classical theme. Let's take a look. World charm and classic colonial grandeur. Famed interior designer Tikka J. Singh's Gurgaon villa is his labor of love. Mr. Singh built this house from scratch, carefully master planning each space for his young family of grandchildren. So even as the interiors reflect his passion for royal English decor, the house retains a warm, welcoming vibe. Tikka J. Singh's specialty is clearly old-school glamour. But how did this English affair begin?
I started my career as a journalist. So I was, you know, kind of specializing on India's trade relations with East European countries. And it so happened that I used to visit these embassies very often. It was almost like a daily affair, you know. So I used to pick up their folders, catalogs, and I used to, you know, see the villas in Hungary, villas in Czechoslovakia, Bulgaria, you know, those East European countries kind of places. So they started fascinating me, and I thought that one day when I make my own house, I'm going to carry all these impressions into my house. So each and every corner of the house that you see is reflecting a kind of old architecture. And secondly, probably I started my schooling in Sainik School Kapurthala, which was based in a palace. So I think that was the, you know, seed grown, you know.
The drawing room is the pride of the Singh residence. Majestic furniture, all manufactured by Mr. Singh himself, rich drapes and fabrics, rare colonial artifacts sourced from art collectors, and aristocratic lighting fixtures. This space transports you into a different era.
If you see the basic color scheme, it's beige, brown and gold kind of a thing. So I think by putting all these kind of things, yadros and things like this, by adding color, blue complements, you know, this kind of interiors very well, just to give a break basically. So I've added a lot of blue things to the fireplace, and that's it. And added some stone here to give a feel of a real fireplace.
The bar adjoining the drawing room is designed like a classic English tavern, with the generous use of wood and leather. The dining area looks fit to host royalty, with the grand dining table and porcelain pottery. Go up a level and this English-inspired villa surprises you with this traditional sitting area.
While much of the Singh's residence bears the English colonial look, but they have beautifully amalgamated the rich Rajasthani and Gujarati decor elements in their bid to support the local folk arts and crafts of India.
A wooden frame on the ceiling lets in the sun to light up this space. What you see is an effortless fusion of classic English furniture and traditional Indian decor.
Basically, this was to break the, you know, totally monotony of the house, you know. Of course, I love English, this thing. But then, you know, being an Indian, staying in India, you know, you want something to look like part of India, you know. And what better place than Gujarat and Rajasthan for this. So I made this wall first, which is totally in bricks, and then we gave it a mud finish, you know, a typical mud finish with mud fusca and all those kind of things I did. And then I made this jali work here. Even if you see the lights over this, they're all totally Indian and Rajasthani kind of lights. So that was the basic idea, to break the, you know, a little flow of the things.
The study area where the interior designer envisions his next project is another classic colonial space with old leather seats and extensive use of wood on the walls and floors. Bedrooms and powder rooms also carry forward the classic old world theme. No space is left unattended, even staircases are tastefully utilized to display their fine art collection. But amidst all the regal finery, the essence of this home is family bonding. A state-of-the-art entertainment room is perfect for lazy weekends. Vintage elegance with Indian accents. Tikka Jai Singh's villa defies convention and inspires one to live life king-size every day. With camera person Zubair Rizvi, Vasudha Sharma, NDTV.
On our home guide section this week, let's talk about air purifiers. In our metro cities, it is now common to complain of breathing problems due to the poor air quality. But air purifiers have become popular as an effective solution for our homes and offices. Take a look.
Air purifiers are small portable machines that eliminate from the air bacteria, virus, and any particular matter that can be inhaled by individuals, and thus provides protection against airborne diseases. It uses only as much power as a common ceiling fan and yet is powerful enough to remove major pollutants like dust, pollen, mold and tobacco smoke from an area. Air purifiers help dramatically reduce pet dander and odor that is a cause of allergies if placed near where the pet spends a lot of time. Among the various air filtration technologies, HEPA air purifiers are considered very efficient. While most air purifiers are capable of targeting bigger pollutants in the air, HEPA-enabled filters can remove smaller particles like dust, smoke, chemicals, pollen and asbestos. Air ionizers are another variety. They create negative ions that change the polarity of airborne particles, causing them to become heavy and fall out of the air that you breathe. Air ionizers are, however, unable to remove odors. Germicidal ultraviolet lamps are another kind of air filter. They are effective at stripping the air of bacteria and other contaminants. But ozone is often a byproduct of the UV air purification process, which is not healthy for regular use. Ozone is a highly reactive oxidant that purifies the air, but its health effects are questionable. While there are no scientific studies to prove that air purifiers improve respiration, but for those who suffer from respiratory ailments, they could provide relief. Air purifiers are effective for individual rooms that average a size of 15 by 15. In India, top brands like Philips, Sharp, Kent and Daikin offer various technologies in air purifiers. Prices range between 15,000 to 40,000 rupees.
For such handy advice on designing or improving your living spaces, or for smart ideas on property buying, tune in to us every weekend, same time, same place. Also send us your suggestions to hotproperty@ndtv.com. Have a good week. Bye-bye.